Students, welcome back. In previous lecture, we have seen what is umbrella activities and what is its four categories, right? So we have seen what is software quality assurance. Now we have to see what is software project tracking and control. Okay, so here project tracking and control, in the sense, as I've already said, project plan will be there. Okay, so the software engineers should work according to that particular plan. Okay, then only what will happen, it will become possible for them to complete their task on time. Okay, so that is known as project planning. So here, this phase, what it will do, it will check whether they are following the plan, whether they are on track or not. Okay, if they are not on track, then what is the necessary action that will be taken so that they will complete and give the software project to customer on time, right? So next one is formal technical reviews. So this is third umbrella activity. This activity will be done to uncover errors and remove errors before they are propagated to next activity. So formal technical reviews, as I've already said, okay, if you are going on, if the software engineer is going on developing the project without checking the error which is present in first module, what will happen after the completion of project, if he or she is coming back and checking the module error, the error which is present in first module, then what will happen? It will just going to affect all the modules, right? So in order to avoid that, formal technical reviews will be done, where software engineer, managers, customers will be there. So weekly, whatever activities they are doing, they will show to customers and managers. They will see that whether it is okay or not. Okay, what is the errors which is present in that? All these things will be rectified, and then only they will move to next activity. Right? That is formal. That is the main advantage of formal technical reviews. Then next one is risk management. So what is risk management means? It assesses risk that may affect the outcome of a project or quality of a project. For example, here in risk management, they will check that if I'm adapting this particular technology, okay, how it is going to be, okay, whether it will create any risk for my project or it will make my project smoothly deliver it to the customer on time. Okay, so this is risk management. In risk management, they will see what is the different parameters which chances are there that it may cause my risk, it may cause some risk to my project. Okay, so here they will see that how that particular risk can be managed. So that is risk management. Okay, so here students, just listen this very carefully. This is one concept, right? Mind mapping. Mind mapping actually is not a software engineering topic. This is a concept of mind mapping, where this is for easy remembrance of things. This is one way of studying. Okay, this is one way of study where you can remember things easily. For example, just take today's topic. Today's one topic which we have discussed is generic view of process layer technology. Now, lots of headings and subheadings will be there, right? So how to remember that easily? For each and every topic, if you are designing mind mapping like this, then it will become easy for you. So in generic view, what we have discussed in definition phase, development phase, and maintenance phase, right? Then in layer technology, what we have discussed, quality, process, methods, and then tools, right? In process, what was there? One is framework activities, another one is umbrella activities, right? In framework activities, what we have did? Communication, planning, modeling, construction, and deployment. Similarly, in umbrella activities, what we have discussed? Software quality assurance, software project tracking and planning, formal technical reviews, and risk management. Okay, so like this, you can draw mind mapping diagram. This is known as mind mapping diagram. If you are drawing diagram like this for each and every topic, what will happen is easily you will remember for which heading, what is the subheading which should come. Okay, so then easily you will remember things. Okay, this is one concept, and I request all of you to follow this then for each and every topic, not only for SC subject, for all the subjects you can follow this method. Okay students, so as an overview, we will see what we have discussed today. In definition phase, what we have discussed, what is the thing which is needed. In development, how that what is converted into how those things will be achieved. And in maintenance phase, what is the errors will be there and how it will be rectified, and what we have seen, what is the new things which should be updated in that software. All these things will come under maintenance phase. When we are coming to layer technology, it is quality, process, methods, and tools, right? Just now we have seen what is communication, with whom the communication will take place between project, between software engineer and customer. Okay, planning, they will do how to achieve the target, and they will modeling, they will construct the blueprint of a software, and construction, they will do the coding and testing, and in deployment, finally, they will give the project to customer, right? So this is the different umbrella activities just now we have discussed just now. software quality assurance, software project tracking and control, formal technical reviews and risk management. In each and every phase, the quality of a software will be assured. Then in project tracking and control, what we are doing, whether the project is on schedule or it is running behind schedule, that we will that the software engineer will track and maintain. Okay. So, and in formal technical reviews, in each and every phase before proceeding to the next activity, whatever error is there, that will be rectified and then they will move to next phase. In risk management, what the software engineer will do, what is the different risk which is associated with that, with this particular software, and how it can overcome. Okay. So this is known as a generic view of process layered technology. Hope you all are clear with this topic. I request you all to go through this once and maintain, take running notes of today's lecture, and like this mind mapping diagram, draw for each and every topic then and there. Then it will become easy for you. Thank you, students.